To help make your class easier for your students to follow, you want to provide a little organization. What we're going to do in this video is to create a heading for a topic, which you're going to want to repeat for each topic, so that your students will be able to easily know where they're at and what they're covering for a particular week. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into our Moodle class. We're going to turn editing on. We're going to go and we're going to do this in topic 2. So when you have your editing on, in the top of the topic, right next to the number, there is a little hand. You can click on that little hand, and then you can do your topic. So this is going to be module 2, and then we'll say getting started in chemistry. Then what we're going to do is highlight that, and we're going to use our styles over here. We're going to do it as heading 1. And if you wanted to, you could even add in due January 20th. We're going to save our changes. And so now we have module 2, getting started in chemistry. And because we used this style, it's brown, so it stands out. In the next video, we're going to talk about creating a table to do some further organization. One of the easiest things to do, and most important things to do, but for some reason often ignored, part of an online course is organization. The easier you can make it for your students to find what they need to find in order to accomplish their goals for the week, the easier it will be for you as the instructor and also for the students to focus on the course rather than focusing on trying to find things. So we've already talked about how to create a topic header, which is what we've got here with module 2. Now we're going to create a table. And so you can actually make this within your topic header, or you can create a new label, insert a label. And then in this label, we can make our table. Now, a table can be really helpful in giving an overview of everything that's going to need to be completed or studied or learned or whatever for a particular module. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a table. However, your table options are sort of limited in this view. So we're going to enlarge our editor. So it'll come up in a new window. And this is the window that we're going to work in. And when you're in this window, you've got a lot of table options. So we're going to start by making a table. And then from here, we can set up how big it is, how many rows, how many columns, that sort of thing. So we are going to set it up to have 2 rows and 3 columns. And we want the width to be 100%. That way it'll grow as the screen grows or shrinks as the screen shrinks. And if you want to put in a border, you can. If you want to do the thickness or the spacing, you can do that. Let's just put in a 2 for our border thickness, and we'll see what happens. Then we'll click OK. And so here is our table, ready to go. And so I'm going to put in here overview. I'm going to put here objectives. And then here I'm going to put in assignments. Now you can make whatever topic headers, whatever headers. Now you can put in whatever table headers that you choose. These are just some that I like to use. And so in the overview, we're going to put in our overview. So we're going to learn how to access the learning management system, navigation, user profile, course settings, and help documentation. This, of course, is coming straight from your Moodle online training course. Yours would relate to your information. Now, what we're going to do is up here on the headers, we're going to choose a heading. So we're going to do heading 2. We did heading 1 for the topic header. This is going to be heading 2. And then for our actual text, we're going to change this to normal. And then we're going to do the objectives. So there's my objectives, and I did the bulleted list by using the bulleted list up here. And then finally, I'm going to put in my assignments. And so this is all; these are all of the items within the course that I'm going to be expecting my students to do. We're going to change this to normal as well. Now, when you do an assignment item, if you name it exactly what you've got it named in Moodle, it'll automatically create these links for you, so that you won't have to relink them or whatever. And so the students, if they wanted to, could just use this table to do their linking. So let's go ahead and go back to our regular editor. And we'll do a save and return, and we'll see what we've got. All right, so right now, our only one that's a little funky is our overview. These both look like they should. So we're going to click back on the update button. And let's take a look. Again, we're enlarging our editor. Let's take a look at our table. So there's something going on with the size of this font that's coming from maybe it was copied originally from Word or some other issue. So we're going to switch to our HTML view. And now you've got all of the text, all of the coding and everything for your table. And so if we find the words that we had for the overview, which was learn, here it is, learn how to access learn management system. And so we see that this is a font size 5. And then we see this is a font size 5. And we have this one doesn't have a font size. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull these out. I'm going to pull out this font size 5. And I'm actually going to pull out this font size 5. And then I'm going to switch back to regular view. And now I lost all of my text. All right, so we're going to fix this. We're going to make these all end up being the same. So we're going to switch to our HTML view. And then we're going to find our text. So here's our text, learn how to access. And so I'm going to take away this font size because this is coming from somewhere other than Moodle. So I'm going to take that font size out. I'm going to take the back side of the font out. Whenever you have a front tag, you have a back tag. So these are this is my front tag. Font size 5, and so I should have a back tag to go with that. Oh, here's my backside. All right, so I'm going to take that one off. Switch back to regular view. Everything's looking the same now. While I'm here, if I wanted to, I can actually change the color of this row. And I can do that with my table properties. So I've got cell properties here. I've got insert a cell, delete a row, row properties. That's actually what I want because I'm going to change the properties just for this one row. So I'm going to do row properties. And then this is where I can set up my alignment. So if I wanted to change my text to align to the center, and let's say in the middle, so it'll be in the middle of each block. If I wanted colors, I can do a background color just by clicking there. My color window will come up, and then I can choose that I want this to be, say, purple. And we'll click OK. All right, so now I've got that purple. Now, if I want to change the font color, I still need to come up here to the text, change my font color. Let's say I change it to white and do that for each of these. Font color, white, font color, white. All right, so that looks good to me. I'm going to put it back to the regular edit mode, save and return. And now I have this lovely table. Now, because I had set up to use one of the styles, I'm getting that tan. So I'm actually going to go back in one more time, and I am going to pull out the change in the font color. So I'm going to turn all the font colors back to black. There we go. Save and return to course. And so now I have purple in the background, then the brown over top. And now I've got my tables in correctly. And like I said, these are named exactly the same as they are named in the class. And so if I click on them, they'll take me straight to that assignment or that activity. So that's all there is to creating a table. Now, usually in addition to I always also like to add with each module a little statement about due dates and times and whatnot and reminders. So within this same label, I'm just going to click on my edit button and we'll go back to our big view. And so underneath of this, I'm going to put in just some basic information. They're going to find everything they need to complete the week, when it's due. And let's change this to 12. Don't wait till the last minute, you know, and I like to put things that, you know, problems with the internet, any other excuses that they can come up with or not, reasons to not turn their work in on time, you know, that sort of thing. You can decide what you want to add, what you don't want to add, but this is, again, just another reminder of their due date and time, and I guess actually my due date should be January 20th, so I'm going to change this to January 20th, and I don't know what day of the week it is. I think it's a Thursday. And again, go back to regular view, save and return to course. And so then for when I do my classes at the beginning of each topic, they will see this information. And then below this will be the resources and the assignments that we'll talk about later. But every week looks exactly. But every module looks exactly the same, so students know exactly what they're going to be looking at each week. When we switch to student view, you see it's nice and neat and not a whole lot for them to look at. One thing you might want to show your students how to use is the show all topics or show one topics. And this is this, right now it's two squares. When all the topics are showing, it's one. And you can take it down to one topic at a time. Then they have this jump to they can use, and because we used the topic header before, it tells us that two is module two, getting started, due. And so if they click on that, it's going to take them right to that module. And so this would work for any modules, although we haven't done the others yet. But it makes it easy for them to find their way around, and it keeps them from having to, you know, figure out where they're at. Also, as the instructor, you can also put the little light bulb on to highlight it as the current week. And then what the students will see, as you can already see that it's turned brown, but again, as the students will see, it's going to show brown. If they show all the week, that one week will still look different, so it's going to stand out for them. So this is just another little indication to help them to know exactly where they're at in the semester. Unfortunately, with Moodle, you can't move a week down and keep it, or a module down and keep it with the same number, so this is a way to keep everything on track. And that's about it. So in here, you've learned about making a table, adding text, using one topic at a time, and also highlighting a topic for the current week. And that was this one. Thank you.